Hello all, welcome to the lecture on Pandas DataFrames. So, we've been looking at the Pandas DataFrames in the previous lectures. So, let's have a quick recap on what we have done in the previous lecture. So, in the previous lecture, we've seen about the data types, the two broad main data types that are numeric and character, which we will be working with often, and what they represent and where we can use numeric and character data types. We also checked the data types of each column to generally know about what are the data types that we are going to work with for the analysis. And we also seen how to get the count of unique data types to get an overall idea about how many variables are there with different data types. And we also seen how to select the data based on data types. For example, if we want to perform any operations only on a specific data type, we can also do that by selecting the data based on the particular data types. And we also looked at the concise summary of data frame, where we've got some information about the data frame with respect to what is the data type of each variables and how many non-null values are there under each column, and which also gave us the memory used by the data frame. And then we checked the format of each column, and we found out that there are few columns that has not been read properly. So, we have gone back and looked at the unique elements of each column to get an idea about what is the reason behind variables being read with different data types which are not expected. So, these are the things that we have seen in the previous lectures, and in this lecture, we are going to see how to import the data. In the previous lectures, we found out that there were question marks and other special characters that are not being considered as blank values. So, now in this lecture, we are going to import the data by considering all of those. After that, we are going to again look at the concise summary of data to cross verify whether there is any difference after importing the data by considering all those special characters or not. After that, we are going to convert the variables data types, because in the previous lectures we have encountered that some variables are of not expected data type. So, in this lesson we are going to convert variables to the expected data type, and we are also going to look at the category versus object data type. What is the effect being a category data type and what is the effect being an object data type. Next, we are going to clean the column door since it has few strings to it like 5, 4 and 3. So, we are going to clean that to make the door's columns perfect for the future analysis. After that, we are going to get the count of missing values to basically arrive at a solution on how we are going to go ahead with the missing values. So, now let's try to import the data by considering the all forms of missing values. So, now basically before importing, we need to know how missing values are being represented in the data set in order to make any reasonable decisions, because you need to be really sure how the missing values are presented in your data frame, whether it is a blank value or zeros or any question marks or with any special characters. So, but we've encountered in our data frame the missing values exist in the form of NaN, which represents the blank values. Double question mark and four question mark represents the missing values wherever they don't have any records for. But we don't have to worry about the blank values, because Python by default replaces blank values with NaN. So, now we know what are the other forms of missing values we have in our data frame. So, now I'm going to import the data considering the other forms of missing values in a data frame. So, I am using the same command as earlier, that is .read_CSV from the pandas library and pd being the alias, and the input being .csv file, and the index I've set it to 0 so that the first column will be treated as the index column, and I've added another argument called NA_values. So, in the argument I've given double question mark and four question marks to basically say consider all these values as NaN values. So, now we have seen how to import the data by considering all forms of missing values in your data frame. Now, let's move ahead and get the concise summary of data frame, because I really want to see the difference after changing the question marks with NaN values, because ideally there are missing values. So, let's check that. So, this is the output that we got before replacing any special characters with NaN. If you see, I have highlighted kilometer and horsepower column. So, kilometer basically had no missing values 1436, but after replacing all the special characters with NaN, so kilometers non-NaN values have been decreased from 1436 to 1421, because all the rest of the values actually being question marks, but that has not been treated as blank values, rather it has been treated as just categories. So, that is why you see a drop in values, that is as 1421. And after that, there is also the similar case with horsepower. Initially, there were no missing values, all the 1436 has non-null values, but when we considered all the special characters with as NaN, it says 1430 non-null values are there, other 6 observations has missing values under horsepower column. So, this step is really important whenever you are performing any analysis. If there are any other forms of missing values that is being encountered in your data frame, you can make sure that you are replacing all those special characters with the default value. So, now we have sorted out the issues where we replaced all the special characters with NaN. We have to solve the other issue by converting variables data type to the expected data type. Because in the previous lecture, we have seen that some of the variables have not been read properly with the correct data type, and we have encountered the reasons as well. Now, it is time to change or convert the variables data type to the expected data type. And asType is the function that is used to explicitly convert data types from one to another. And the syntax being asType of data type, you can basically specify to which data type you want to convert it to, and you have to use your data frame name. So, here I am interested in converting the metallic color on the automatic variable to object data type, because those values represents just the categories to it. I am going to convert them to object data type. So, how I am doing here is, I am accessing the metallic color from the cars_data, and using the asType function, I am converting the metallic color to object by giving object inside the function. So, whatever I am doing here, that should be reflected back to the original variable. That is why I have equated that to cars_data of metallic color. So, now metallic color has been converted to object. Similarly, you can try that for automatic. So, I have done it here. I have converted the automatic variable also to object data type, and I have reflected the changes to the original variable as well. Now, we have converted the metallic color and automatic to object data type, but we have already seen there are 2 data types that the Python can handle with respect to character data type. One is being category and another one is being object. We have already changed everything to object. There is also another data type called category, right? So, let us see what is the impact when we have these metallic color or any categorical variable as category or as object. So, here is a slide which will illustrate the impact of variables being category and the impact of variables being object data type. So, nbytes is the command that is used to get the total bytes consumed by the elements of columns. We are going to look fuel type as object data type and fuel type as category data type. So, I am going to get the total bytes consumed by the elements with respect to object data type as well as category data type. For that, nbytes can be used, and the syntax would be n dimensional array dot nbytes. So, it can be n dimensional array, and you can use nbytes from it. So, I am using, like, I am accessing the fuel type from the cars_data frame, and I have used dot nbytes to get the total bytes consumed by the elements where the fuel type is being object. So, when the fuel type is being object, it has consumed 11,488 bytes. When it is of category, so here if you check, I have converted fuel type to category, and then I am checking the total bytes consumed by the element of the column, but it has drastically dropped down to 1460 bytes. So, this is the advantage of keeping categorical variable as category data type instead of keeping them as objects. So this will be really useful when you are dealing with a huge amount of data and you want to reduce the space that is being allocated for each and every variable or for each and every cell. So in that case, you would go for category data type for all the string values that you have in your data frame. But in our case, we are just dealing with a less amount of data, so there is no need to explicitly convert the variable to category. But if you see, we are going to go ahead and keep the fuel type as object, and this slide is just for the illustration purpose. And we have changed the data type for few variables. Now I want to recheck the data type of variables after all the conversions that I have made. So I am again checking the concise summary of the data frame course data using the dot info command. If you see, now all the variables are of expected data type. For example, kilometer is of float, metallic color is of object, automatic color is of object. So now we have to clean the column doors, because in the previous lecture we have seen that under the doors column it has some string values to it. So I just want to recap what we have seen in the doors column. We have checked the unique values of variable doors. It turned out to have some unique values which are in numbers as well as in strings. So those basically represents 5, 4, 3 in numbers. So there might be cases where they have wrongly typed the numbers in terms of strings. So now if you want to have a consistent values, like if you want to only have numerical values like 2, 3, 4 and 5, you can always go back and change all the string values to numerical values by using a command in Python. So the command is replace, that is used to replace a value with the desired value. You can replace any numerical to string as well as string to numericals. So the syntax would be dataframe.replace. Inside the function I have used the value to be replaced, and after that the second argument would be what is the value that you are going to replace it with. So here I have problem in three strings. So using the replace command, I can replace all the string values to numbers. So let's take the string 3 first. So I am accessing the doors column from the data frame cars underscore data, and by using dot replace command, the first argument that I have used is the value that should be replaced, that is 3, and using which value, that is the number 3, and I have used in place is equal to true, so that the modifications done in the data frame will be reflected back in the data frame that you are working on. Similarly, I have done it for all the other strings like 4 and 5. So now I have replaced all the string values to numbers. We don't want multiple values which represents the same meaning. Now I have a consistent values like 2, 3, 4 and 5. So now this is not the only way where you can replace any value with the desired value. There are several functions that does the same. One is using where. So you can try out where function from NumPy, but you can also use the where function on Pandas libraries as well. So you can try that out to replace all the string values with the numbers. Now it's time to convert the doors to int64, because whatever levels you've added, whatever values you've replaced it with, it will create it as a new set of values, because Python can't differentiate between the existing set of values and the newly added values. So it will basically create new set of categories. For example, 2, 3, 4, 5, again it will have 3, 4, 5, because that is the categories that we have added newly. So in that case, let us convert them back to integer 64s, so that 2, 3, 4 and 5 become the integer data type that represents the number of doors being 2, 3, 4 and 5. So as we know that I can convert them back to integer 64 by using the command as type. And have reflected the changes to the original variable doors. So this is to basically have the existing levels as it is. If we replace any values, that will get added as a new level rather than updating it in the original level. So just to avoid that confusion, I am reconverting them back to the integer data type. So now we are done with cleaning the doors column. So now we have to check whether there are any missing values in your data frame or not. So to check the count of missing values present in each column, dataframe.isNull.sum will be used. Basically, isNull is a function which gives you an output in terms of Boolean values, that is true or false. So, it will consider the whole data frame because you are applying the isNull on the data frame. Wherever you have missing values, it will be represented as true. Wherever the cell does not have any missing values, it will be represented as false. And I have used dot sum to sum up all the true values because I am interested in getting the count of missing values present in each column. So, that is why I have used dot sum after isNull. So, this is the input that I have given, cars underscore data dot isNull dot sum, that will give me the missing values present in each column. So, under the price column, I do not have any missing values, but if you see under age, we have 100 missing values present under the age column. So, here is the output for the command isNull dot sum. So, under the price variable, we do not have any missing values, but if you see the age variable has 100 missing values and the kilometer variable has 15 missing values. Similarly, fuel type has 100, horsepower has 6 and metallic color has 150 missing values. So, now we know that there are some missing values under each columns and the missing values are not same across all the columns because it is differing with each variables. So, we have to come up with a logic approach to see how we are going to fill those missing values or how we are going to deal with these missing values at all. So, let us summarize whatever we have seen in this lecture. We have imported the data by considering all the other forms of missing values as blank values. By default, Python takes it as none. After imported the data, we have got the concise summary of data where we have checked the difference after replacing all the special characters with NaN values. We have also converted the variables to the expected data types. Next, we have seen what is the impact of having a variable with the data type category and having the variable with the data type object. And we have also cleaned the column called doors where it had few strings to it and we have replaced all the strings to numbers. So, now we also have an idea about how many missing values are present in each column. So, in the upcoming lectures, we will be seeing about how to go ahead and deal with the missing values by imputing those.